This is testing the relationship between religious attendance and attitudes toward marijuana legalization. This is the GSS 2012 data set. We test this hypothesis by seeing the percentage of those who favor legalization of marijuana by comparing across values of attendance at the same value of the dependent variable legalization of marijuana. And indeed, the relationship would appear to be quite strong. 62% of low attenders favor legalization. It drops to 46 among moderate attenders. And then it's all the way down to 26-27% at high attendance. So the, end to end, it's about a 36 percentage point decline in those favoring legalization. Now, when you look at a simple, what's called a gross relationship like this, you have to begin asking the question, when we compare low attenders, say, to high attenders, we know we're comparing on a religious attendance, but in what other ways might these groups be different from each other? What compositional differences also go along with the difference in religious attendance? For example, low attenders might be more likely to be young. High attenders might be more likely to be older. And if age is related to attitudes toward legalization, it could be age and not religious attendance that's causing us to see this effect. Or perhaps low attenders are less likely to have children than are high attenders. If having kids is also related to one's attitudes on marijuana, it might be the kid variable, the kid effect, if you will, and not the attendance effect that we see in here. In fact, I looked at the data, and these low attenders are substantially less likely to have children than are high attenders. So that's a compositional difference that could be affecting our testing of the hypothesis about religious attendance. So in this chapter, we're going to learn to control for a third variable. We're going to talk about a relationship between an independent variable and a dependent variable controlling for a third variable. In SPSS crosstabs, I'll go here to Analyze, Descriptive Statistics, crosstabs. Here's the, I have it set up from the analysis we just looked at. A 10-3, which is a measure of religious attendance, is the independent variable, goes in the columns. GRASS is the GSS variable that measures attitudes toward legalization. And then, of course, I have set percentages to be column percentages. So this is set up according to the rules. In controlling for a third variable, we click that third variable into the layer box. There's a variable in here. It's a dummy variable. Let's look at the coding. It's called kids. People who do not have kids are coded 0 on this, and people who do have kids are coded 1 on this. So it's a 0-1 variable. Just click that into the layer, 1 of 1. I'm going to click OK. I'm going to look at this. Here you go. This is a SPSS control crosstab, and but let's make sense of it. What did SPSS do? It went through the data set, and it separated out everybody who did not have kids. So it found everybody who was coded 0 on the control variable over here, and then ran the relationship between attendance and marijuana attitudes. Then it ran through the data set again and picked up everybody who did have kids. And we can focus on the top cross tab and the one right beneath it. Let's evaluate this relationship for people who do not have children, who are coded 0 on kids. Here's religious attendance. We're going to compare across the legal row here. Well, we can see about 72% of low attenders without kids favor legalization. Drops to 56% among moderate attenders, and it's only about 37% among high attenders. So just focusing on that relationship, we can see that the attendance effect, if you will, we can call this the attendance effect, is about 35 percentage points. It's a very strong relationship there. So let's just call that an effect of about 35 points among people without kids. All right, let's drop down here and see what the effect is among those who do have children. As you work across values of a 10-3, you can see that about 56.5% of low attenders with kids favor legalization, drops to 42.7, and then drops down to about 25% among those who are high attenders. So even here, among those who have children, we see an attendance effect persist. So that effect is about 32 points. In fact, the effects, just in terms of strength, and we're measuring strength by percentage point differences here, are very similar between for people without and with children. It's about 30, between 32, say, and 35 percentage points. It's very similar. We can also get a handle on this relationship by seeing if the control variable has an effect and what that effect is. Notice among low attenders, 71.9% without kids favor legalization, and notice how that drops to about 56.5% among those who do have kids. So the kid effect among low attenders is on the order of 15 percentage points or so. In fact, you see that virtually the same effect for moderate attenders, 56 drops to 42.7, and even among high attenders. Look how the support, even among these folks who are the most reluctant to favor legalization, it drops down by, I don't know, about 12 points or so. So the kid effect is about 12, 13 points or so. The attendance effect is about 32, 33 points or so. This is a very common form of what's called an additive relationship. It's an additive relationship because the direction is the same at both values of the control variable. That is to say, high attenders are less likely to favor legalization at both values. And importantly, and here's the distinction, the size of the effect. The size of the effect is very similar at both values of the control. So if someone were to ask you, what's the effect of attendance on attitudes toward marijuana legalization, you wouldn't have to qualify your statement. You could say, oh, it's about 33 points or so. And then someone might say, what's the effect of having children? And you would say, oh, it's between 12 and 15 points or so. So additive relationships have this symmetrical, simple quality. Both variables are contributing to the explanation of the dependent variable. Each variable on its own is accounting for some of the differences among people. And you can explain between 25% and 72% of graphic space or of analytic space between people, knowing two things about them: how often they go to church and whether or not they have children.